is huge iceberg. The ice front is now about the same position as it had in 1962. So the ice had been advancing for 40 years by about a kilometer per year, and now due to the calving, it's back to the position, to the extent it had in 1962. We are a little further south already than in 1962. We're certainly the first ship to sail here, and as we are heading further down south into the Bay of Whales, we will certainly be able to even sail further south than the 7831 we're reaching now. So the Klepnikov had many first ever during the history of the ship, and today is another one. And apart from that, and all these figures and statistics and carving offs of B-15, it's just great to see the Ross Ice Shelf over there on our starboard side, more than 400 miles. That's the coastline. And it's fed by hundreds of glaciers flowing down here from the polar plateau. It was discovered by James Clark Ross in 1841. It's the great barrier all the early explorers had to traverse before they actually could get further into the Antarctic continent and head for the South Pole. And now you get a first feeling of it. It's about 30 meters high on an average. It's a big, big floating piece of ice. The size of it is about the size of France, which is quite a big European country. And we have been sailing along it now already for more than 24 hours, and it's still extending further to the east. Our speed at the moment, 15 knots, our course exactly 090, 90 degrees. So we're just following the ice up now further to the east. And we're not quite sure when we will be reaching the Bay of Whales, sometime around noon. But due to the calving of B-15, of course, also the position, the size, and the shape of the Bay of Whales will have changed. So we don't know what's awaiting us. Only twice has a passenger ship been there before. Both times it was the Klepnikov. But now the whole thing has certainly and probably dramatically changed. So it's going to be an interesting day. And while you're looking out there to the Ross Ice Shelf in quite decent weather conditions, we must say, we just want to quote Louis Bernacchi again, and you find the quote also in your daily program, and it probably describes best the Ross Ice Shelf. And he said, nothing was visible but the great ice cap stretching away for hundreds of miles to the south and the west. Unless one has actually seen it, it is impossible to conceive the stupendous extent of this ice cap, its consistency, utter bareness and stillness, which sends an undefinable sense of dread to the heart. It's a quote by Louis Bernacchi, who was a physicist under Scott in his expedition, British Antarctic expedition, and that's probably what the Ross Ice Shelf is all about. The great barrier down here at the very end of the Ross Sea, and we're just sailing along it now in a very special position at 78 degrees and 31 minutes south. So you've seen the biggest iceberg in the world yesterday, and now you're just at the position where it calved off, and all of you are the first ones to ever see this so far. There have only been satellite pictures, nothing else, and we are chartering the whole area here, and Harry is doing a great job since the very early morning hours. Get him some coffee from time to time, and then you'll be mentioned in his foreword when this all will be published, and it's of course very important to